Well, the classic comic strip Ginger Meggs has been around, can you believe it, for 94 years. And
wow,
that makes it Australia's... well, it makes it Australia's oldest comic strip, appearing daily in 120 newspapers in 34 wow. countries. Our favourite redhead was created by James Banks. And the fifth artist to draw Meggsy is Jason Chatfield, who joins us now live from New York. Hey, Jason.
Hello, good to be with you. Thanks for having me.
Now, how does a boy from Karratha end up drawing one of the most iconic comic strips that the country has ever seen?
Well, I started drawing when I was very, very young, and that's all I ever did. I walked around and just drew everything that I saw, and I didn't really do anything else. I wasn't great at sports, wasn't super social kid, bit of a geek. And so I just sat and drew all day, and eventually, you know, something that was a hobby turned into a job. And when I was about 23, the cartoonist for Ginger Meggs at the time, James Kemsley, he asked me to, a few days before he died, he asked me to take it over. Very generous Aww. And talented guy. So that's how we find me here now.
And is that how it works? Is it sort of one of those things that's passed down from the previous drawer or the previous artist to the next one? Do they just decide, or is there an estate that decides? I find it fascinating.
Yeah, I mean, that side of it is kind of fascinating. There is an estate that decides. The creator's family, Jimmy Banks' family, they're in charge of the trademark of Ginger Meggs and all of that official stuff, and they... it was a combination of the artist and the family kind of approving the next artist. Because, as you say, it's been passed down through four other artists before me, and it is an Australian icon. You know, it's a really important responsibility. So they had to make sure I wasn't completely crazy. A little bit crazy.
Why do you think it's survived for so long, darling?
By the way, I have to say, ding dong, lifelong dream to be able to talk to you. Anyway, I think it survived.
Thank you so much.
I'm sorry. I love you to death. Anyway, I think it survived because it's quintessentially Australian. That's why I loved it when I was growing up. I used to read it as a kid myself. I was a fan. I was a huge fan. And I loved it because it was Australian. It wasn't Bart Simpson. It wasn't Calvin and Hobbes or Dennis the Menace. It was Ginger Meggs, you know? Like, he was in Australia. He did Australian things. He talked like Aussie kids. And that's what endears him to people. He's that quintessential Aussie larrikin. And that's what he still is now. Like, that's what he's always been. Except now, you know, he goes to 34 countries and a lot of other people see him.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Mm. Jason, anything else you'd like to say to Ding Dong before I ask you another question?
Just that I love you. Anyway, sorry, you can ask. I'm sorry.
You're so gorgeous. Aww. Thank you. And I love you.
Oh, how divine. It's a love fest. Now, Jason, you say that, I mean, Ginger Meggs is quintessentially Aussie, but you work in New York, so how do you come up with your comic strip from your American
yes.
base?
Well, it can effectively be drawn from anywhere. It doesn't matter where it's drawn, as long as it's drawn by an Australian and written by an Australian. What's actually happened since I've been drawing it from here, which is only temporary, by the way, I'm not taking him offshore forever, it's that you get more Australian. You know, when you're around a lot of other cultures, like especially in New York, where it's every culture in the world, you end up Australianing a bit more. So Ginger's actually become a bit more Aussie than he ever was. You know, he doesn't say hi, he says g'day, and he doesn't say my, he says me dad, you know. There's lots of little things that you realise are quintessentially Australian once you're among other cultures and go, oh, that's just a thing we do back home. So... if anything, it's made him more authentically Australian, which is what the syndicate that sends him around the world, they're more concerned that he stays as Australian as possible than anything else. So that's what I've been doing. That's my responsibility.
And there is a special exhibition celebrating 94 years of Ginger Meggs at the Museum of Sydney. It runs until this Sunday, the 25th of October. Jason Chatfield, lovely to speak with you.
Yeah. Nice.
Ginger Meggs is a very good hand.
Thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate it. Love you, Ding Dong.
Lovely. Oh,
everyone loves you. We're just so honoured to have you on the panel this week, Ding Dong. Filling in for Ida.